Welcome to Verbal Programming, where we simplify programming with easy to understand whiteboard videos. And today I'll be sharing with you how does different layers in blockchain technology work and what does the so-called terms of layer 0, layer 1, layer 2 and layer 3 mean in the crypto world. So let's get started. Now, as we all know that blockchain technology is an amalgamation of various technologies coming together under one roof to help the system run smoothly. To name a few of them, it includes mathematical computation, cryptography, game theory, peer-to-peer systems, and validation protocols, which essentially join forces to power blockchain operations. Further, since blockchain eliminates the presence of a central governing authority, all transactions must be robustly protected and data must be stored securely on a distributed ledger. And for this, blockchains have a layered architecture due to which they are able to facilitate a unique way of authenticating transactions. In the architecture, there are five layers involved, each with its distinct functionality. Now that we know the importance of these layers of blockchain technology, let us dive right in and understand the architecture and what each layer does. Starting with number 1, hardware infrastructure layer. To understand this layer, we must understand that the blockchain data lies securely stored in a data server, and when we browse the web or use any blockchain apps, our machines request access to this data from the server. Here, the framework that facilitates this exchange is known as client-server architecture. As we all know that blockchains are peer-to-peer or P2P networks that allow clients to connect with peer clients to make data sharing faster and easier, it is nothing but a vast network of devices communicating with each other and requesting data from one another. And this is exactly how a distributed ledger gets created. And here, each device communicating with another device on the network is a node. And also, each node here randomly verifies the transaction data as well. Next, number 2, data layer. So, as we all know that blockchains are nothing but a long chain of blocks containing transaction data. When the nodes validate a certain number of transactions, the data is bundled into a block, added to a blockchain, and linked with the previous block of data. Here, the genesis block is the first block in the chain and therefore does not need to be linked with any of the previous blocks. Instead, the subsequent block is linked with the genesis block and the process is repeated every time a new block is added. And this is how a blockchain is formed and continuously grows progressively. Further, here, every transaction is digitally signed with a private key of the sender's wallet address, and only the sender has the access to this key, thus ensuring that data can neither be accessed nor be tampered with by anybody else. This is what we call as finality in the blockchain terminology. This digital signature also protects the owner's identity, which is itself encrypted, thus ensuring maximum security and anonymity in the network. Next, number 3, network layer. Now, as we all know that P2P framework of blockchain enables various nodes to exchange transaction data to arrive at a consensus about the validity of the transaction. This means that every node must be able to discover other nodes on the network for fast communication. And it is the network layer that facilitates this inter-node communication. And as node discovery, block creation and block addition are also managed by this layer, it is also referred to as propagation layer. Next, number 4, consensus layer. Now, this is the most critical layer in the blockchain operations because this layer is responsible for validating transactions, and without it, the entire system will fail. This layer runs the protocol that requires a certain number of nodes to verify one transaction, and therefore every transaction is processed by multiple nodes that must then arrive at the same result and agree on its validity. Further, this framework maintains the blockchain's decentralized nature, So as by ensuring that no node has sole control over any transaction data and the role itself is distributed. This is what we call as the consensus mechanism. With so many nodes processing transactions, bundling them up and adding them to the blockchain, multiple blocks may get created simultaneously, resulting in a branch in the blockchain. However, there must always be a single chain block addition, and it is the consensus layer that also ensures that this conflict is resolved. Next, number 5, application layer. This is a layer on which smart contracts and decentralized applications or DApps run. Smart contracts make decisions based on a certain triggers, such as contract expiration dates, achievements of spot prices, etc. The actions that follow these decisions are executed by dApps. And all of this happens on the application layer. If you want to learn what are smart contracts and what are dApps in detail, I'll recommend you to watch the following videos. Link for each is given in the description below. Back to our video, do note that dApps also facilitate the communication between user devices and the blockchain. Therefore, the application is like the user-facing front-end, while the main blockchain is the back-end, where the data remains securely stored. So, in all, as a summary, you can state that these are the 5 layers of a blockchain that help it function smoothly. And now that you are aware of the blockchain layer architecture, you might have heard of these terms like layer 0, layer 1, layer 2, and layer 3. Let's look into each of these terms individually and what do they mean. First one being, what is layer 0? This layer consists of the hardware and the equipment that are required to run the network and the consensus mechanisms without any glitch. It also includes the internet connection, which is used for the blockchain network's communication. Next, what is layer 1? Well, this layer governs the protocols that ensure security across the blockchain network. Layer 1 includes the consensus mechanism, coding languages, and all the rules embedded in the code for the operations of the blockchain. Therefore, sometimes this is also called as the implementation layer. And do note that when users mention the Bitcoin blockchain, they are referring to this layer. Next, what is layer 2? So, we do realize that to improve the throughput of blockchains, processing power must be added. But doing so means the addition of more nodes as well, and this clogs the network. However, as mentioned earlier, the addition of nodes is critical for maintaining the decentralization nature of a blockchain. This means that if either scalability, decentralization, or security are tinkered with, they will affect each other on layer 1. This is called the classic blockchain trilemma, wherein by blockchain's scalability, we refer to its ability to handle a higher volume of transactions. By security, we refer to its ability to secure data on the blockchain from various types of assaults and the blockchain's defenses against double spending. And by decentralization, we mean it as a type of network redundancy that ensures that the network is not controlled by fewer entities. Hence, if seen practically, layer 1 cannot be scaled without moving all the processing to a separate layer built atop the first layer, that is layer 2. This is made possible by enabling the integration of third-party solutions with layer 1. The result of layer 2 is nothing but a new network that handles all the transaction authentication and decongests layer 1. Therefore, layer 1 only handles the creation and addition of blocks to the blockchain, and the new layer 2 network sits over the layer 1 network and continuously communicates with it. The Lightning Network is an example of layer 2 blockchain sitting on the top of Bitcoin blockchain. Next, what is layer 3? Here, we have smart contracts and dApps that only handle decision making and execution of follow-up actions. Since the maximum functionality of the blockchain is derived from the innovation of dApps, This is the layer that interfaces between the real-world applications and the underlying layers that facilitate everything. Lastly, as a conclusion, I'd like to say that in the case of blockchain architecture's distributed network, each network participant maintains, authorizes, and updates new entries. Hence, a collection of blocks with transactions in a specific order represents the structure of blockchain technology. And while these can be saved as a flat file, that is somewhat of a TXT file, it can also take the shape of a simple database. And do remember that blockchain architecture can take public, private, and consortium forms as well if needed. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you love my content, feel free to smash that like button, and if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.